I recently just had another PowerMac G4 MDD donated to me. Got the original box and still has all the goodies in there, which is kind of cool to see. This is it. Looks just like my last one. My last one was a dual 1.42. This is a dual 1.25. But the kicker is this. My friend who had this before me overclocked that to a 1.5. So this is actually the fastest MDD that I own. It's got a disc bay and another one. This is my first SATA disc I'm going to be putting in there. It's 250 gigs. I'm going to order another one. It's a funky little cooling thing for it. This is 512 megs of RAM inside here. This would get it started, but we're going to order four more of those. This is a Radeon 9700 Pro that I flashed. We're going to see if it works. I haven't tested it yet, but it should work. Here's our big old gold heatsink here that we've all seen before in my previous videos. Some of you are wondering why these PCI slots are so big. Well, they're actually 64-bit PCI slots, which is really incredible in 2002. This is Apple's AirPort slot. If you want to buy an upgraded card, you could just stick it right in there and you'll have wireless. These drive cages are really easy to take out and in. There's a little lever right here. You just pull it and move the drive upwards. And it comes right out. And it actually holds two hard drives. But like my previous G4 upgrade, we're going to put a cooler instead. Apple uses four RAM slots, upgradable to 2 gigabytes of RAM. So order the GeForce 7800GS. We're going to replace this Radeon with the GeForce. A little tech savvy stuff is this is actually not a ZIF or a slot processor. This is actually a daughter card. You can see the outline of the card. The Mirror Disk Door G4 is the only case that supports two CD-ROMs. If we zoom in real close here, we can see that the plastic film is still left on the doors and the bezel surrounding the doors. And yes, these are actually mirrors. SATA card is installed. Well, we got our memory in, so let's install it. Alrighty, just received my 7800GS OC in the mail. She's in there. Mullock's power's connected. Let's see if she works. Here we go. Fingers crossed. We've got a nasty sound back there. It sounds like it's the card too. Hold on. Well, there we go. Must have been. The fuck is that? Looks like it's hitting on my drive cage bay. I'm gonna take this thing off right here because when the case closes, the fan sits right on top of this, and I think that's what's hitting it. So let's see if that's, yep, it was this end plate. Check it out. She works. Right now we're running some pretty time demos just to see, make sure it's running up to par and all that stuff, and it's looking pretty good for a frickin' G4. Some of you might be wondering how you get wireless inside of a G4. And most of you will say, well, you have to get the little AirPort card that plugs in the board. Well, they're about 50 bucks on eBay, and they only support wireless B. Here's what you do. You go on eBay, you search for a PCI wireless card that has the Broadcom chip. This cost me 20 bucks, and it has wireless G. The reason why I have to have the Broadcom chip is because that's the one that the Mac uses. So the Mac will see that as an AirPort card, which is pretty cool. This is pretty much what it is. It's a PCI wireless card, and it should be recognized by the Mac. See how fast it takes us to install this wireless card. Please tell me why.
OS 10 recognizes this bitch. Come on. Give me airport. Give me some airport. Look at that.
That's how you get airport for 20 bucks. Nice. We put in a wireless G network card. This acts as an airport extreme. We got this cool two-port SATA card. 7800 GS OC. And remember that little fan rail I had here? Well, I just took the fan and I put it back here. See one hard drive under here. Hard drive is back there against the wall. And they're both cooled.